Hello everyone and welcome to another video. It's been a while. I don't make one video because there was not much things to do. It's summer, it's very hot here in Qatar, and I've been riding mostly in the evening when there is not enough lightning. Today I want to talk about my bike, the Specialized S-Works Venge. I want to do a long-term review on it. Things I like about it, things I don't really like about it. So yeah, let's get into it and find out more about the bike. I've been riding the bike now for almost 2 years. I bought it in February 2021. It's a model 2021. It's the latest one done by Specialized, the model Venge, which came out in 2019, the latest one. This shape, I mean. The bike, I have it since 2021, February. I order only the frame online. This is actually a build-up. So I was doing like stripping parts from my old bike, the Cannondale. I ordered the frame online and I put together everything. At first I had Ultegra DI2 on it with Vision wheels, and then I upgrade to Dura-As DI2 11 speed, and then later on I order some more parts. I ordered the crankset, the S-Works power meter crankset, then I changed that one into rotor, and now I have the S-Works but without power meter, just the carbon crank. As well, I ordered about 6 months ago the Bora, Campagnolo Bora wheels, which are amazing. I will do a review on them soon as well. So this is my bike. You have seen it in the latest videos. Also, I upgrade the chain ring. I have absolute black as well. Dura-As front derailleur, Dura-As rear derailleur with ceramic speed oversized pulleys, which are amazing. They are a bit loud, but I love them. I have an Ultegra cassette, it's 1125. My chain is KMC limited edition X11TT. You can find it online as well. I ordered it from a shop here locally. I have it now for almost 1 year. The color of the bike is dove gray. It has some contrast on the painting here. And this is the Aerofly, S-Works Aerofly 2 handlebars with S-Works stem. I also have the S-Works power mirror saddle, which is amazing. I used to have the S-Works power normal one, but this one is a bit more comfortable for me. I don't know how it works for everyone else. The model, as I said, is Venge in a size 54. I am 179 centimeter, almost 180. So this is what I can ride. For the power meter, I'm using the Asioma Favero dual pedals. As I said, I just changed the crank. I put the carbon one, but without power meter. For the wheels, I have the Campagnolo Bora WTO with ceramic bearings. They are really, really amazing. 60 millimeter deep section. I love them in the wind, headwind, they go like through the butter. In sidewind, actually, they are not good. But in headwind, tailwind, they go very, very nice. Okay, let's talk about things I like about the bike and what I don't really like the bike. I like it because it's a very aggressive bike, like it's very fast. In headwind, it's very fast.
and tailwind is extremely, extremely fast. Like sometimes you just don't need to pedal and the bike, it glides. Another thing that I like, it's pretty light for an aero bike. Without the pedals, I have it at 7.5 kilo. With the pedals, I think almost 7.8 kilo, which for an aero bike, it comes at a very, very good weight. One thing I don't like about it at very long rides is not very comfortable because of the position you have on it. It's very aggressive, as I said, but it will hurt a little bit your neck. This is on a long ride. I guess this is the only thing I don't like about it, because it's not a comfortable bike, like for long rides. For short rides, if you're riding 100, 120 kilometer, it's okay. Once you pass the mark of 200, which I did three times until now, it's pretty uncomfortable for the neck and for the palms, because the aero position. This is just my opinion. It's a long-term review, as I said. Maybe some of you have a different opinion. I want to point out another thing that I'm glad I didn't start it with this top-end $12,000 bike, because I would have not appreciated what this bike can do. And I would have never seen the difference between an entry-level bike and a top-end bike. Like, when I started my cycling path, I started with a $1,000 bike. And then I saw that I'm not improving on it. I wanted something better. And I bought a Trek Emonda SL5, which is like, I remember, around $2,000 or $2,500. Pretty good bike with 105 group set. And that bike, I rode it for, I guess, 2 or 3 months. And then I wanted something better, of course. And I got my Cannondale System 6, which was my first aero bike. And I saw a huge difference between a climbing bike Emonda and the Cannondale System 6, which is a aero bike, and I loved it. Like, I really loved that bike. I rode it for almost 1 year before I took this bike. And when I took this bike, I saw a huge difference. Like, from the System 6 to the Venge, it's unbelievable, the difference. But if I would have gotten this bike first, I would have not appreciated how fast it is, how beautiful it is, how good it rides. So that's one point that I want to say. Always start your cycling path with an entry-level bike, something cheap. Maybe you're gonna crash in the first 2 to 3 months of your riding. You forget to unclip, you're gonna crash maybe. Or maybe you don't brake enough and you crash into someone. You don't want to crash this bike. This bike, Duras, they are very expensive. Like a front derailleur or rear derailleur, it's $700-$800. Not to talk about the levers, the shifting levers, which are, I believe, close to $1,000. Like, if you crash with 105 or with Ultegra Mechanical, they are cheaper to replace. As well, the frame on a entry-level bike is cheaper. Normally you're gonna have aluminium, so you don't have to worry. But if it's carbon, you don't have to worry about crashing like $1,000-$1,500 bike. You can replace it. But if you crash this beauty, it's gonna hurt a lot. Another thing I want to talk about is the tires that I'm using. I've been using now Continental GP 5000 tubeless for a while, and I have no complaints, like no issues at all. I had never had a puncture. I had the small punctures, like they sealed automatically because they have the sealant inside, which does its work very, very well. I'm using the Continental sealant. So yeah, I don't know. I just love them. I will never change them. I will never go to Vittoria Rubino or to Pirelli, even though I heard Pirelli they are pretty good, the tubeless edition. But I still love how Continental GP 5000 they ride. They feel. They are some good tires. They have good grip. I get out about 6 to 7 thousand kilometers from a pair, which is amazing. It's like almost one season. In a year, I tend to ride 10 to 11 thousand kilometers. So in 1 year, I change like two pairs of tires. And the price point is very good. You can get them at about $100-$120 maximum with the shipping. If you can't find them on your local shop, they are everywhere online. I was saying that is not very comfortable, the bike on long rides. I have a friend who has the S-Works SL7, the new aero and climbing bike from Specialized. And they are saying it's a mix between the Tarmac and Venge. And that is true because it is very comfortable, beside being very light. At some bikes being below 7 kilos, 6.8, 6.9 kilo, you can easily get them to that weight. But it is very comfortable. Like the minute I sit on an SL7, it was my size as well, 54, with it was different saddle, but that doesn't make any difference because I was riding the same saddle before, the S-Works Power, not the mirror that I have, just the normal one. But the comfort I was feeling, it was like immediate comfort. Okay, it's a different bike, yes, I understand, but it's a racing bike, so it should be not very, very comfortable. But no, SL7, it's very comfortable. So if you're looking to get really good comfort on the Venge, you're not gonna get it because it's a very aggressive bike. It's aero, so it's pointed to cut through the wind, to make you go fast, and that's the main reason that they make it like that. So my advice from being into the cycling industry now for like serious for the past 2 years, 2.5 years almost since the pandemic, is if you want to get into cycling, start with an entry level bike and work your way like step by step, work your way up. Start with a rim brake, because when you're going to move to the disc brake, you're going to see the difference. Start with mechanical group set, because when you're going to move to the DI2, you're going to see a huge difference. And I know everyone, including me, is saying like, oh, I will never ride DI2, maybe it runs out of battery. No, you can have the Bluetooth. It's a very, very small piece. You can plug it in to your next to your battery, and you can connect it to your phone or with your Garmin, and it shows you how much battery you have all the time and in which gears you are. It's the technology on DI2 is outstanding. It's unbelievable. And the shifting speed, it's lightning. Like you'll never experience something like that with mechanical, never, even with a Dura Ass mechanical. So I was the same at the beginning, riding mechanical. I was like, no, I'm never gonna get into DI2 because you can run out of battery problems. Like, yeah, I had some issue when the cables, they disconnected in one of my shifters, but the issues, they can be fixed very, very easy. I mean, it's nothing that will require very big changes. And the battery, you just have to be careful when to charge it. If you don't have the Bluetooth, normally at around 1,000-1,500 kilometers, if you're not shifting a lot, the battery will last up to 1,500 kilometers. So that's around 3 to 4 months. Depends on how you shift, how often you shift. Yeah. So yeah, work your way out from an entry-level bike to a top-end bike if you are serious about cycling, because you're gonna appreciate this kind of bikes. If I would have started, as I said, with this bike, maybe I would have gotten bored of it very fast. Maybe I would have not appreciated the beauty of it, the riding style that it has. So yeah, so that's it for the review of my bike. If you want to know more things about it, let me know in the comment section. Oh, I forgot to say, the bike comes with a ceramic speed bottom bracket, which is something that adds a lot of value to the frame, because to buy separate, to upgrade, if you are buying the frame without a bottom bracket, to upgrade to ceramic speed bearings, it costs around $300, something like that. So it's a nice thing that all these top end bikes, they come with ceramic speed bottom brackets, which is, it gives longer life to the bearings if they are serviced proper, which also requires a service at 4,000 to 5,000 kilometers. So every 6 months, I would say, you have to service it. Depends on the riding condition, but here in Qatar, since we don't have a lot of rain, which is only 3 months per year, and in that 3 months maybe it rains a little bit, few times. I haven't ridden this bike in any rain condition yet, and I'm not looking forward to it, because it can affect a little bit the drivetrain, so I'm avoiding that. But is the sand actually also affects a little bit the drivetrain, but less than the mud and rain, which they are very common in other parts of the world. Yep. See you next time when I'm gonna do a review about the wheels. I have them, as I said, for about 6 months now, and I have some nice things to say about them, because when I was buying them, I was looking for reviews, and they are not many on YouTube. So see you next time.